Look at 1 Samuel 18:10 and see more assumptions. And it came to pass on the morrow that the evil spirit from God came upon Saul, and he prophesied in the midst of the house. And David played with his hand as at other times, and there was a javelin in Saul's hand. The evil spirit from God. The evil spirit from God. Look at 1 Samuel 16:14. Another assumption. But the spirit of the Lord departed from Saul, and an evil spirit from the Lord troubled him. Evil spirit from the Lord. If the evil spirit is from the Lord, why did Jesus say, in my name you shall cast out demons? If the evil spirit is from God, we shall have a collection of evil spirits. Yes, because if it's from God, we should be the custodians of evil spirits. But why will Jesus ask you to cast them out? Why will Jesus cast them out? It shows that the evil spirits cannot be from God. So that must be an assumption. Just like he killeth and maketh alive. They are all assumptions. So why will they call it an evil spirit from God? Because they assume that God was part of the entire process. What actually the evil spirit functioned in was the absence of God's presence. The functionality of the evil spirit is the absence of God's presence. Evil spirits can only function when the presence of God is absent.